Okay, good afternoon. Okay, so as we were talking about reproduction, that means fertilization in humans. So in fertilization, we talk that both the male and the female gametes are responsible. Okay, that means sperm in its male gamete and ova or egg, which is female gamete, is responsible for fertilization. That means to produce a new one. Okay, to produce a new one. Okay, so in this case, what happens? Sometimes what happens? The ova or egg, which is released by the female body, okay, in the fallopian tube, okay, from the ovaries towards the fallopian tube, is either blocked, okay, blocked by fallopian tube. As we all know that egg is produced from the ovaries, okay, and it is moved to uterus, okay, through the fallopian tube. It's a tube like structure in once in 4 weeks. So in some cases, what happens, from this fallopian tube the egg is not released in the uterus. At that time, what will happen? Male and female will not fertilize, okay, because there is no egg. यहीं पर ब्लॉक हो गया. यूटेरस में कहां से आएगा? इन यूटेरस देयर विल बी नो एग. सो ओनली स्पर्म कैनॉट प्रोड्यूस अ जायगोट. सो इन दिस केस व्हाट हैपेंड? आर्टिफिशियल सेमिनेशन और IVF, इन विट्रो फर्टिलाइजेशन. Fertilization is done, which is also called test tube baby. Understood? So as we know that in fertilization or reproduction, okay, the female body is responsible for formation of zygote and formation of foetus. But if there is no fertilization, what will happen? Then baby can't be produced. So in that case, this method is mostly used. That means this method is used outside the body. So fertilization takes place where?
Inside.
Not inside, outside the body, by taking out the ovary and sperm of male and female gametes. Okay, outside. So male sperm is taken, female sperm is taken, they are fertilized. And after fertilization, but they are fertilized not in a random way. It is fertilized in certain condition. As in ki idhar bhi aise fertilize kar lo, it's not possible. So it is done medicinally. It is done medically. So where sperm and egg is fertilized outside the female body. Got it? Okay, after that, after fertilization, what happens? What is formed? Zygote is formed. So then zygote is formed. When zygote is formed, again for the development it needs a body. Because how do that this zygote get nutrition? It's not possible to get it outside. Okay, so what happens? This zygote is again placed inside female body. Okay, after fertilization this zygote is placed inside the female body. And as we all know, when zygote is formed, it gets attached automatically, okay, and it gets the nutritional value. And again, after, when it is put inside the female body, it develops normally. It develops normally. Got it? Okay. So this is called IVF or test tube. IVF or test tube baby. Okay. This is done in most cases where a parent doesn't have a baby or can't produce baby normally, naturally. Naturally they can't produce because some problem is there in fallopian tube. Some problem is there in fallopian tube. But another important thing, if the sperm is of not good quality, then also baby is not produced because fertilization doesn't take place. Okay, understood? So in this case, both can be responsible. Both can be responsible. Male also can be responsible and female also can be responsible for not having a baby. Always remember. Okay, it's not that only from the female body, if the egg is not produced, then the baby is not produced. No, even male also can be affected. Means they also are responsible. That's why, have you heard about what it is called, the nasbandi? Okay, so in nasbandi, what happens? The vas difference is cut. Vas difference is cut. Okay, that means in female body we have fallopian tube to transfer egg, whereas in male body we have vas difference to transfer sperm. Okay, so if this have a problem, if this is also blocked, then also baby will not produce, means fertilization will not take place. Got it? So both male and female are responsible for having baby and for not having a baby. Okay, and this is called artificial fertilization. This is called artificial fertilization, which is also called in vitro fertilization or test tube baby. Got it? So baby doesn't come out from the test tube. Okay, only zygote is formed in the test tube. After that it is placed in a female body. Got it? Okay, so this was all about fertilization. Now let's move to viviparous and oviparous animals. So what do you mean by viviparous and oviparous animals? So as we already know that birth of the individual can take place directly, okay, from the female body or through by giving eggs after fertilization. So after fertilization, the birth can be of any type. Okay, that's why the egg that we eat, what is it? It is the egg of a female body. Okay, it is egg of a female body, and the egg that we found in market, it is not fertilized. It is not fertilized. So we can't say that that is a non-vegetarian. Okay, that is non-vegetarian. We can't say that is categorized in another factors, that is egetarian. Okay, so leave that thing. We will talk about viviparous and oviparous. Okay, so viviparous, viviparous animals, and oviparous animals. Oviparous animals. So we have categorized animals into two parts according to how it give birth after fertilization or after formation of zygote. Okay, so the animals which give birth to young ones are called viviparous, which give birth to young ones are called viviparous. Example, mammals, you can write mammals. Okay, in mammals we have humans also, we have cow, we have dog, we have goat. Okay, they give birth to young ones directly when the fetus is developed, fully developed. Okay. Example: cow, buffalo, cat, dog, human beings, etc. The animals which lay eggs, which later develops into the young ones. That means animals which lay eggs and development takes place later. Takes place later. Okay, later means not in the body, outside the body. Okay, not in the body, outside the body. Example, we have frog, lizard, hen. Frog, lizard, crow, hen, means mostly birds you can write. Okay, most birds you can write. Birds and reptiles you can mention, and birds you can name any: pigeon, hen, crow. Okay, you can name any. So viviparous animals give birth to young ones where development of the fetus takes place inside the female body. Okay, and after it is developed, the new one comes out. Okay, then in oviparous animals, the animals which lay eggs, okay, the animals which lay eggs after fertilization, and the development takes place outside the body. Okay, inside the egg. Okay, from the yolk part, that means the yellowish part. Okay, so viviparous and oviparous. Now, as in case of reproduction, right from the beginning, we are using the term same kind, isn't it? I'm using the term same kind. That means if a dog is fertilized, okay, from dog a new individual of same kind is come. That means dog will only come, okay, as a new individual. For plants also, okay, if you grow a seed of mango, will it grow in lychee? No, it will grow of mango. Okay, that means it will develop. Okay, that means young ones to adults, that means change in growth. Okay, so in some cases this same kind can be different at initial stage. Okay, at initial stage it can be different. We will talk about that. As for example, have you seen a butterfly? But butterfly lay eggs in the leaves, and that butterfly give eggs, and from the eggs, does the butterfly come out? No. First of all, what will come out? The larva, then pupa, then it will change. That means at initial stage, at the first stage, what happens? The organism is of not of same kind in that case, but at later stage it will acquire the same thing. Okay, so the individuals which are either born or hatched from the eggs continue to grow till it becomes adult. That means growth is a continuous process. And we keep on growing till we are no more. That means till we are dead, we grow. Still we are growing. Okay, still we are growing from inside. So in some animals, the young ones look different from the adult. That means all animals, that means young ones look same. Okay, a baby looks same, that of cow or that of dog or that of humans. The baby will have same appearance. It has ears, it has eyes, it will develop hairs. Okay, same thing. But in some animals the young one looks different. Example, look different. This is exceptions. Example, we have butterfly. Okay, we have example, we can write one butterfly. We have frog is also there. Good. Toad or frog. Okay, because they give birth and the tadpole doesn't look like the frog. Okay, doesn't look like the frog. Okay, so example, the caterpillar of silkworm looks very different from the adult moth. The tadpole larva looks from the adult frog. So that means we see total difference. Okay, but it will change into a same kind after a process, and that process is called metamorphosis. This is the process by which the differently looked individual of the same kind is changed. Okay, is changed by this process. Okay, by this process. So the transformation of the larva into the adult silkworm and that of tadpole into the frog through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. Okay, that means the transformation of larva to adult butterfly and tadpole to frog is called metamorphosis. Is called metamorphosis. It is the term given. It is the term given. It is the process by which larva is changed into adult, okay, butterfly, and tadpole is changed into adult frog. Okay, to look similar. That means to look similar or to attend perfect growth or perfect adult. Okay, so in human beings, however, the body parts similar to this those present in the adults are present in the young ones even at the time of birth. But human beings, okay, even birds also when they hatch, what will happen? They have wings. Okay, hen also have wings. Okay, so that is of same kind, but in case of butterfly and in case of frog, okay, the young ones which is hatched, that is of different type. Okay, it doesn't look like an adult. Okay, the tadpole doesn't look like an adult because tadpoles have gills, they have fins. Okay, whereas adult frog have lungs and they have legs. Gills is not there, gills is removed. Okay, removed means it will change, and that change is called metamorphosis. The change in the body structure to attain the similar kind is called metamorphosis. Got it? Okay, so this was all about oviparous and viviparous animals.